Everybody who is here now, and those who are around the world on internet seeing us. Let your word guide us in this journey to eternal life. That's a humble prayer in the name of Jesus Christ,
our Savior. Amen.
Now, we are going to talk about something which we love most. What is that? If I ask something which we love most, you will find out that everybody has his own thing that he loves most, which is quite different from the other one. But before all that, there is a hymn which I like so much. It is 7-1 in Kinyarwanda, I believe. I will request everybody to stand with me. Thank you so much.
Murakoze cyane.
The choir.
Abaririmbyi.
I thought Brother Batista and the group, they are the only singers we have here. God bless you so much. Now, what did you hear in the song that is so much important? I heard in the song that I don't care about the riches of this world. I don't mind whether I'm poor. And then I thought about someone who may ask. Supposing they told you that you were rich now, can you refuse it? The chance is coming to you. Can you decline it? We work and we suffer every day. We are sweating because we want to be okay. Yes, it is. Last time, Brother Ben said, I'm happy now. God saved me from the jail. Now I'm independent, I'm free, I can work, and I'm going to school. Why was he happy? Because he's now striving by himself to see where he can reach. Why do I work every time? It's because I want my family to be okay, even I myself. There is a very big question now. Clothes, all respect, all honor. We can, in English, we have many words which we can use. In Kinyarwanda, we have said icyubahiro. But in English, we have many words that mean, or may be used there, but specifically we mean honor. To be
honored.
This, the ministers, the councillors, the mayor, those politicians, we call them honorable. Yes, honorable.
Yes, nyakubahwa.
The pastor, we don't say honorable.
Pastor, on how to go nyakubahwa.
Bentley, very smart as he is, we cannot say honorable.
Bentley, to shura kutaba ngo nyakubahiro.
Brother David seated with his wife, in his respect, the way you see them, we cannot say honorable.
Urukureba David n'umufasha kuzo bicaranye baberewe, hari je tavuga ngo banyirecubahiro.
Aunt Martha, who is so much able to guide the children, who is so much loving, she does the work of God, she does many things, we cannot say honorable. But you see someone who has come there, you don't know him, but you respected the guest. I mean, you expected the guest. And then you see him come in, you are like, yes, sir. Sit here, sir. Honorable. Then you see a very good lady who has come with big earrings. She's wearing the other shoes, which are best, they call them what? High heel. She has glasses on. She's looking like this. Then she's doing like this. You are like, oh yes, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Sit here, ma'am. Honorable. If at this time, by surprise, the local church where I was born, where I was grown up, if they see me now, they can find out the richest person in the village who has good chairs. I just reached there now, like in the middle of the sermon during divine service. They just see me there. And the preacher who is in front will be like, oh my. The elder will be starting to not understand what to do now. Then the deacon, where is he? Immediately they go to the richest man around in the village. They bring a very good chair. Because in the church there is no chair on which I can sit.
Hand
it to them. Why? Where is he going to sit with his
suit?
This man from America. They remember me when I was still young. When I was putting on the pants which have holes behind here. And a guest would come. They make me stand up. I go outside because there is no space for me in the church. The guest has come. At this time, even the deacon or the elder in the church there, they can make him go out so that I get space. Reason why there is nobody in the church there dressing like me. Honorable, welcome, sir. Someone important from America. This is a big problem in the world today. This is a big problem in the church today. We have forgotten what we want. We don't know whether we want to be honored or to be dressed well. We don't know whether dressing and honor is different. We think dressing well, that is to be honored there. No wonder the devil also in heaven wanted to be honored. That's why he said, I must be above God. And then everybody who worships God is going to worship me instead. There are some people who train others to be calling them Father. Father, whoever comes up, that is a
Father.
Please. And I remember when I was still young, we used to see these priests, and everybody would be scared because the Father has come. And everybody's like this. Everybody's like this. You keep a distance. And you must be sincere in your heart. You forget that the only Father to be honored to that extent is God. But here where we don't have that priest, where we don't have that Father, yet we have the Most High God. Everybody's just walking like he's going in the field. As if you're walking in the bathroom. As if you're in your own house. You see the brethren. You think they are useless around the world. This is a big problem. And the question is, if it wasn't in the church, you would say the word is spoiled, is destroyed. That's the word is doomed. That's how the word is. Then we're gonna run away from the world to the church. Unfortunately, you run away from the world to the church. It is even worse in the church. Because someone will shift from that pew to the other corner because he's seated with Batista, whom he hates so much. And he will march out immediately before the sermon is over. He's not comfortable, but this is seated in the church. But if there comes someone whom we don't know, that's because he's dressed well. He came, you know, here in America, since I came to America, I've never seen the car. Maybe they are there. But according to my eyes, I have not seen those cars we use to call so much expensive in Uganda, called Prado. I don't know how we call them.
Prado.
Every rich man was striving to buy Prado.
Prada.
Okay. Thank you. They call it Prada.
Mm.
Every rich man was striving to buy that one. And then one day, a certain pastor from
Kenya
came to
Uganda.
He was having, you know, these cars which have remote control. It was our first time to see it. So he came with our bishop. They parked somewhere. And it was a Prada. Everybody was, please don't touch on that car. And the pastor was walking. Everybody is trying to go away to keep a distance. Don't touch on him. And for him, he was trying to reach to everybody. And because the way he was looking, everybody was like, please, those kids. Oh my God. So all the people surrounded the car. They were so much amazed. What kind of a car? But who came in that car? They want to see the person who came
in that car.
And the man, he remembered that he did not lock the door. In the church where he was, he pressed the button. Of course, remote has power to go all over the other side. And the car was like,
woo-hoo.
It just moved a little bit like this. Everybody took off. The car is moving without someone. What amazing, what expensive, what a rich man with this car. And now they went to the church to see the pastor. Everybody wasn't caring what what the preacher is saying. But all the focus is on the pastor who came with the car. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Yeah, we.
And now the kids were being beaten because they are moving around. They are being beaten, mistreated there because an expensive person has come there that day.
ngo ni wewe bari kwanduza imodoka ya pastor.
Let's read in the Bible.
Some muri Bibiliya.
Someone can read for us in James.
Somera muri Yakobo.
Chapter 2 verse 1.
Kabiri ku murongo wa mbere.
We shall go slow slowly.
Tugenda gora gora. Yakobo kabiri murongo wa mbere. Turasoma. Ari kuvuga ngo bene data kwizera kwanyu mwizera umwami wacu Yesu Kristo w'icyubahiro ntikube uko kurobanura abantu ku butoni. Nihagira umuntu uza mu itorero ryanyu yambaye impeta y'izahabu n'imyenda yakataraboneka akinjirana n'umukene wambaye ubushwambagara, namwe mukita ku wambaye imyenda y'akataraboneka mukamubwira muti wicara aha heza, naho wamukene mukamubwira muti wehoho hagarara iriya cyangwa wicare munsi y'agatebe k'ibirenge byanjye.
First end there. Thank you. Let's read in English. My brethren, have not the faith of our Lord Jesus. I beg my pardon. My brethren, have not the faith of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord of glory, with respect of persons. Verse 2. For if there comes unto your assembly a man with a golden ring in goodly apparel, and there come in also a poor man in vain raiment, and you have respect to him that wears the gay clothing, and say unto him, sit you here in a good place, and say to the poor, stand you there, or sit here under my footstool. Remember what I was telling you. Every child and the poor person who is in the church is going to be told to stand up, stand in the behind there, or go out, because someone to honor has come in. Yes, it happened several times. The problem in the world, in the church or even outside the church, be it in political way or any other social way or even in the church, why struggles and fight every time? It's just because people love those who are of their own class. Then those who are not in my class go away from me. I remember in my language, way back home, they say that there is a saying that the rich man talks with the rich man. If you don't have a cow, what am I going to... No. It's not a cow, but a cattle.
You know?
But even if you have only one cow, then you will join the group of the rich people who have cows. However, still they will be underlooking you. When you talk, they are like, you just have one cow, you stupid man. What are you talking about?
Why
When we are choosing a leader, we are like, that one is not educated to the level, so he cannot do the job. Even in the church, as if God wants your education, God wants your money, God wants your whatever. But what does God want? What does God want? Let's read verse 4. Are you not then partial in yourselves and are become judges of evil thoughts? When you see how someone is dressed, you think that one is righteous. And then the one who comes in filthy clothes, rags, we cannot allow him to stand in front here because he is a sinner. He cannot talk anything. What are you saying? Yet he has his potential within him. Did you read the verse 4?
Mbese iyo mugenje mutyo ntimuba mwirobanuye mukaba abacamanza batekereza ndakwiriye.
Verse 5, continue.
Murongo wa 5. Nimwumve bene data bakundwa, mbese Imana ndiyatoranije abakene b'iby'isi ngo babe aribo baba abatunzi mu byo kwizera barakwe ubwami yasezeranije abayikunda.
Okay, amen. Actually, someone who had that verse would have said amen. Let's read in English. Here, my beloved brethren, has not God chosen the poor of this world rich in faith and heirs of the kingdom which he has promised to them that love him?
Amen.
This verse says God chose the poor people in this world and he allowed them to be rich in faith. He allowed them to be rich in getting the eternal kingdom. That's why when the Jesus said, it's very hard for a rich man to go to heaven than the camel to pass through the needle, the eye or the hole of the needle. Do you know those needles? Have we ever done so? Do you know that small hall where we pass the thread? Or you know the serum, the injection, the shot? You see that small hall? Jesus said, it is so simple for the camel to pass through that needle than a rich man to go to heaven. What does it mean? Does it mean then we stop working? Does it mean then we should be poor intentionally? And when you become poor, you begin grumbling and cursing God, then you begin stealing. You will not go to heaven because God said, never steal. Never covet. Never be jealous. Never admire things of your neighbor. Unfortunately, even the rich people admire the property or the things of other rich people, even those of the poor people. I remember there is a certain rich man who moved all the people on the village. He said all the land is his.
He decided
to set fire on each and every house so that they can go away. All those miles are mine. Yet he's burning the houses of the poor people. What did verse 5 say? Do we want to be honored because of clothes? Which honor is sent down here? Or we want the honor that will be everlasting in heaven? The everlasting honor does not depend on your clothes. The everlasting honor does not depend on your education. The everlasting honor does not depend on which language you speak. People have killed each other around the world just because they don't speak the same language. Because they are not of the same tribe. Because they are not of the same race. Racism all over in the world. Verse 1 says that remember, we believe we have faith in Jesus of honor. Jesus of glory. Actually, this verse, this version, uses the word glory. Which means you may be honored, but then you don't have glory. Let me tell you this. The other honorables which we were talking about, they are not more respected like a king. Do we have kings here in America? No, we don't have kings here in America. In Africa, we have kings. Look, this fellow in Uganda, the Kabaka of Uganda, those who love him, those who are sincere, and if you don't show that you are sincere, then it will be trouble to you. When he's come, or you hear that he's coming, everybody will fall down on you and fall down. No matter whether you are dressed in white or what, down. Because the king needs that glory. But the president, we don't just fall down. Yet he's someone with all that security guard. But we don't fall down. When the pastor comes, we don't fall down. We just look at him like this. We don't want to give him even the seat. The pastor, the servant of God. And the king who says, kill him for no reason. Everybody will fall down because he's going to kill us if we don't do. God who gives us freedom to do what we want, we just take him like nothing. We don't even know who God is. Dear brethren,
when is that?
Let's today think. If we need to be honored just because of the way we are, little forgetting that we have to be with a good standard spiritually, this is the high time when we change our course. Yes, it is the high time when we are supposed to change our course. Younger people around the world, I've been to see. There are some boys I've been talking. There is my friend. Thank you for coming, brother. I'm glad to see you today. God bless you. Pendo.
Pendo.
They are there. I see you all, younger people. Let me tell you. This swearing we do every time. And your mom calls you, you are just like, hey, shut up. What?
Kiss.
You think you are above? You think you are big? She speaks Chirundi. And you're not Chirundi. You don't want to answer her in Chirundi. She speaks Swahili. You understand Swahili. You don't want to answer her in Swahili. You want to show her that you are expensive now. She doesn't know how to say hi, but because for you have gone to school, you are in America where they speak English. You want to show that you know English now. With your poor accent like mine. With all your stupidity as you are, you forget that the devil is using you. What does the commandment say about parents and children? Respect. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Actually, there is a way, the Bible, there is a certain word used. Respect. Your father and mother. Even some other translations say, Anna. Anna, call her honorable. She's honorable to you. You are the king. Anna, your father and mother, so that you can have much life in the land that God gives you. Gives you more years. People are being jailed just because they don't want to listen. Even some people are jailed because they have been segregating their fellows. People have killed each other just because of that. Let's end with verse 9. It says, but if you have respect to persons, you commit sin and are convinced of the law as transgressors.
Ariko niba murobanura abantu ku butoni muba mukoze icyaha mutsinzwe n'amategeko yuko mwacumuye.
If you see how beautiful the other one is, you see how much friendly he is to you than someone else, you see how respected he may be according to how he's dressed, you see you take him in another class because of the language, the character, the tribe, the word, whatever he's rich. He says, you commit sin. You commit a sin and all the sinners will go to hell. I did not say who is the sinner here. Because that is not my concern. If I do like this to you, all these fingers are pointing back to me. Which means you have to check yourself and I have to check myself too. The word of God is a double-edged sword. It cuts all sides. And if I hold it badly, it may cut me too. That's why when God speaks, He does not segregate. He's talking to humankind all over the world now. Let's fight for the glory of God. The everlasting glory. The everlasting honor. Where we shall live eternally. Not to be honored today, tomorrow we are nowhere. Not to respect someone today, tomorrow he's nowhere. Let's be poor now. Accept whatever situation in which you are, where God put you. Just know that God is taking care of you. If you go back to verse 5, I remind you. And he says, he chose the poor people of this world to be rich in heaven. Yes, Mama Naomi.
Amen.
That's it. That's the word of God. If we want to be rich in heaven, then we shall take him at his word. If we want to be poor in heaven, then we shall do the opposite. May the Lord of mercy give us power, give us courage, give us understanding to know how we do the choosing. May the Lord lead us to everlasting honor, the everlasting glory. In Jesus' name we pray.